Well, whoever they are, turns out they were right. Sunshine, the good times. Yeah, we got.
Take a deep breath. We are gathered together in the presence of God and family and friends to join together this man and woman in the bonds of holy matrimony. This is both a serious and joyous occasion for us to be together as we celebrate a new life that begins with Justin and Taylor. Our Lord Jesus predicted that a time would come when a man and a woman would leave father and mother and cleave to each other and be joined together, they would become one flesh. So as we begin, let us go to said God in prayer as we start this ceremony. Let's pray. Our Father in heaven, Creator, Savior, and Designer of marriage, we turn to you asking that you be glorified by what takes place this day, that this ceremony would honor you and reflect the seriousness of the vows to be spoken. Might this service be a reminder to those who have spoken vows in the past? Might it be instructive to those yet considering such a commitment in their future? And may this ceremony be a fitting beginning for Justin and Taylor as they commit themselves before this audience to each other. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Taylor and Justin, this day is finally here. From strawberry pie at Shoney's, to be blending a life together, your love and commitment to one another has reached a significant milestone, this wedding ceremony. This is not what you had envisioned for your big day together, but I am thankful that you all have continued on for one very significant reason, and that is to prove that nothing can stop love. One of the great aspects of your vows and part of the reality of marriage is to have love no matter the circumstances. And while I know your families are heartbroken that many of them cannot be here today, you are exhibiting a fundamental trait of marriage in your commitment to one another and to this marriage. Ephesians 5:31 says, "For this reason a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh," quoting Genesis chapter 2. The scriptures speak of the oneness that you two shall have after this wedding ceremony, and this oneness that you have should be based on three commitments that I want to give to you all this day to remember. They're short, by the way. The first one is I want you to be one in your commitment to each other. The Bible points out clearly the need to leave your parents and to cleave to one another. Your commitment should be willfully, sacrificially, and unconditionally to accept and to love each other. This type of commitment is a must for your marriage to be a success. In other words, there are no maybes in your vows. As was mentioned that by the Apostle Paul in Ephesians chapter 5, Genesis 2 verses 24 and 25 says, "Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." Be committed to one another. This is a covenant that is made before God. Ruth Bell Graham has said, "A good marriage is a union of two good forgivers. You will need to learn to forgive, but in forgiveness is love, your commitment to one another." Know that marriage is a total commitment and a total sharing of a total person with another person until death. So I challenge you to be committed to each other. Number two, I strongly urge you to be one in your commitment to your future together. You are no longer going through life alone. Your ups and your downs, your successes and your struggles, the joys and the pains will be experienced together. Though the context was not marriage, I believe the sentiment definitely fits. Well, Ruth tells her mother-in-law Naomi in Ruth chapter 1, verses 16 and 17, "Do not urge me to leave you or to turn back from you. For where you go, I will go. And where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people, and your God, my God. Where you will die, I will die, and there will I be buried. May the Lord deal with me, be it ever so severely, if anything but death separates you and me." As you walk through life from here on, I want you to walk through life together. Like I said when we were talking about marriage in our counseling, Genesis 2 says that a man that woman was made from one of Adam's ribs, not from a bone from his head, thinking that woman is above man, nor a bone from his foot, thinking that man is above woman, but from his side. Thomas Adams has said, as God by creation made two one, so again by marriage he is made one of two. To walk side by side throughout your lives together is what you are going to do from here on out. Commit yourselves to one another this day and for the rest of your life so that you will always help one another through the difficulties and celebrate with one another in the delights. Third, and most importantly, I want you to remember that you are making this commitment before God. For it is God Himself that is joining you today, as Jesus said in Matthew chapter 19, verse 6, when He said, "Therefore, what God has joined together, let not man separate." Christian writer Max Lucado said, "God created marriage. No government subcommittee envisioned it. No social organization developed it. Marriage was conceived and born in the mind of God. Since God made marriage, this union is solidified in God. The vows you are about to say to one another are said before God. And so I will say again, therefore what God has joined together, let not man separate. No one or no thing is to come before your vows that you are about to make to one another. Let God's own love and faithfulness to us be the example that you follow for each other." So, if you are ready to live out these three commitments to one another, I want you to look into each other's eyes, and I know that you have prepared vows for one another. And I didn't ask this beforehand. Who goes first? He goes first.
Sorry. Darling, I know this isn't exactly how we plan things, but if there's anything that we both know and that we both learned best, is that even though plans change and things don't go the way we may want them to all the time, as long as we're together, we're okay. I promise today that I will always be by your side no matter how much life changes. I love you more and more every day, and I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you.
My turn. I can't believe we're here. We've been waiting on this for so long, for this very moment. Even though Rona can't stop us.
Fat.
When I think about us, I think about this cheesy, crazy love, storybook love. It's all the cheesiness in it. You came into my life at such a hard time, and you brought me into the light. You brought me to the sunshine and the better parts of life. It's hard to believe we're here because of strawberry pie, so many nights in that Shoney's parking lot. We've been through so much, gut-wrenching, emotional, hard, bad times, but we've been through a lot better times. I've had some of the best moments of my life with you, and this is only the beginning. I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you, finish out this crazy life with you.
Justin, do you have a ring as a symbol of your love and commitment to Taylor?
Yes.
The wedding ring is more than just an ornament or a piece of jewelry. It is the symbol of absolute. It is a symbol of absolute and total commitment of one person to another in marital love. It has no ending, symbolizing the unending love and commitment to which you have vowed to this woman. It is also symbolic of the vow that you have taken not only before this crowd here, but also primarily before God. This ring is both a sign and a seal of your vow and is to be a ceaseless reminder of the commitment that you are making to this woman. Place the ring on the wedding finger of your bride and please repeat after me. With this ring,
with this ring,
I thee wed, and with all I am,
and with all I am,
and all I have, I honor you. Taylor, do you have a symbol of your love and commitment to Justin?
Yes.
The ring you have received represents an eternal commitment on the part of your husband to love you always. The ring that you are about to give carries with it the exact same commitment. This ring is to be a ceaseless reminder to you that your love for your husband is to be second only to the love that you have to your Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Place this ring on the wedding finger of your husband, and please repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed, and with all I am,
and with all I am,
and all I have,
and all I have,
I honor you.
I honor you.
As we close this ceremony, let us pray together. We thank you, our Heavenly Father, for this home that is now called into existence, and we ask your blessing upon Justin and Taylor all the days of their lives. We pray that as they unite into one family, we ask that you strengthen them, that they might glorify you, and that they can help, encourage, and love one another for the rest of their lives. Bless them to this end, for we ask it in the name of your precious Son, Christ Jesus. Amen. By the power invested in me, by the state of Tennessee, and as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I am happy to pronounce you husband and wife. Justin, you may kiss your bride.
Pop, pop, pop.
Yeah.
Yay.
Woo! I didn't say this beforehand, but I now present to everybody here,
yeah,
Mr. and Mrs. Justin Hogan. There you go. Congratulations, y'all.
All right, honey.
Yeah. Well done. Excellent, y'all.